Jesus could trust the Holy Spirit. And he did. Jesus staked everything that he had on the Holy Ghost. Remember that. Never forget it. The Son of the Living God staked absolutely everything. And I do not mean to be sacrilegious when I word it just as I have. I mean it just as I've said. When Jesus walked this earth, he was as much man as he were not God. That's the reason he could have yielded to temptation. If Jesus could not have yielded to those temptations, then those temptations would have been a farce. And the secret of those miracles and the life and ministry of Jesus was the Holy Spirit. That same glorious resurrection power that walked into that tomb and raised Jesus from the dead. And when Jesus went away, this to me is so thrilling. Love is something that you do. You can't love without giving. You just cannot love without giving. Remember that wonderful conversation that Jesus had with the Father? When he reminded the Father, when he said, "These that thou hast given unto me." The church, this glorious body of believers. "These, Father, that thou hast given unto me." And you and I are God's gift to his Son. The church is precious. Oh, if you only knew how precious is the church. How precious is the bride of Christ, if you could only understand. Sometimes we get glimpses of it. But often I wonder how many of us realize how precious is the church. It's God's gift to his Son. How precious is the bride of Christ. It's the Father's gift to his Son. You can't love without giving. You can't. That's the reason. Just before Jesus went away, he gave to the church the greatest gift that was possible for him to give. There was no greater gift that Jesus could give to his own. There was no greater gift that he could give to the church than the person who'd been so faithful. The one who had not failed him. "Ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you." What power? The same power that had been manifested in his ministry, in his life. The one who had not failed him.